Hi, I'm Nina and I'm a customer experience specialist here at Sherpany. Today, I'm going to show you how you use Sherpany to get time back. The Sherpany app is available as native iOS, Android and Windows app, as well as a web application. In this introduction, I will specifically show you the web application. If your mobile or tablet is managed by your company, you will need to ask your IT department to install the Sherpany app. The advantage of the apps is that once they are synced, you also have access to your documents offline. Now let's take a closer look. By now, you should have been invited to join Sherpany by your admin. Log in at app.sherpany.com with your email, your password, and the code that was sent to your mobile. Here we are logged in. Upon logging in, you will see your timeline. It shows all of your past and upcoming meetings. Depending on how many meetings you have, you can switch the views above to daily, weekly, monthly, or quarterly. Click on the Today button to easily find the meetings for today. In the timeline view, you have an overview of the meeting name, the date and time of meeting, the number of documents and unread documents, number of comments and unread comments, and the assigned group. Let's take a look inside a meeting. Here we see the agenda. Many of the agenda items will have an attached document for your preparation. Let's open one of these documents. I'll show you how to make annotations. In this toolbar on the upper right corner, you can find all your annotation tools. You can add a text note like this. And you can mark certain areas on the document. And if you have an iPad, for example, you can use your Apple Pen to write down your annotations directly on the document. If I click here on this icon, I have a full overview of all my notes. I've already started preparing for this meeting and I made several annotations in here. The annotations view serves two purposes. First, it gives me a summary of where I made my notes. And secondly, it acts as the navigation. I click on an annotation and I'm immediately brought to the point in the document where I made that note, comment, or mark. At this point, I would like to point out that all of these notes are private and only you can see them. Now, let's take a look at the public posting of comments. This feature is essential for collaborating before a meeting and allowing for agenda items to move along quicker. If you want to add a comment, you'll need to locate the blue plus. And when you add a comment, your name will appear and be linked to the page you are commenting on. Should you have a question for a meeting member regarding the document, you can use the @ sign to tag the person and notify him or her. Each time you make a comment, the admin will receive an email. And unless you use the @ sign, no one else will be notified, but the comments will be visible to anyone reading the document after. To summarize, the annotations function allows you to prepare for your meetings privately. And the comments function is there to help you collaborate with others before the meeting. The last section that I want to show you today is the library. The library is separate from your meetings and holds documents that are generally applicable to your firm. These documents are not related to a specific meeting. Think of the statutes of the firm and policies. The room admin uploads these documents and labels them. These labels allow you to filter your documents easily. And speaking of filtering, we also have a full search function. This search will scan all documents for the words and phrases you're looking for. And finally, if you have any questions, you can click on the question mark here at the top to find our FAQs and contact support via chat, email, and phone. And there you have it. If you have any questions, your customer success manager and our customer happiness engineers are available for support.